We all know the importance of sleep, but everyone's sleep needs are actually different. Dr. Malika Marshall, Medical Director for Everyday Health, is here to explain what's behind our sleep needs and how to wind down and achieve a better night's sleep. Dr. Marshall, great to have you here.
Thanks for having me, Tanya.
So there are some people who are genetically blessed and simply need 5 hours of sleep. Is that right?
Apparently, German researchers have found that there's a small percentage of the population that can probably get by on just 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night. We're talking about a very small minority, maybe up to 5% of people. So for the vast majority of us, American adults, we need about 7 or 8 hours of sleep a night.
7 or 8 hours. But it is genetic. This need is something that we've inherited from our ancestors.
That's right.
All right. So what are your best tips for a good night's sleep? What do we need to do?
All right, so the best thing to do is actually have good sleep habits, which I know easier said than done, right? But you really need to try to get to bed at the same time every night on the weekdays as well as the weekends. Get up around the same time. You want to fall asleep in a quiet, dark, cool place. You want to do something relaxing before you try to go to sleep. So you shouldn't be on the phone. You shouldn't be watching TV. You shouldn't be playing words with friends like I do.
Put down the laptop.
Put down the laptop, absolutely. You know, read a book for 10 minutes and then try to snooze. If you find that you've been lying in bed for 30 minutes and it's just not going to happen, don't stay there and make yourself crazy. Get up, go into another room, do something else, and maybe 30 or 40 minutes later, try again. Other important things to do are to avoid caffeine late in the day, avoid alcohol, which actually can help you fall asleep, but then you tend to wake up earlier than normal. Avoid tobacco. Don't exercise right before you go to bed, although exercise earlier in the day is actually very helpful. And if you do a lot of those things, I think you're going to find you're going to get a better night's rest.
And if we are, you know, like so many of us, not getting enough sleep, how does this compounded lack of sleep affect us?
In many ways. So, you know, at baseline, it's going to make you grumpy and irritable. It increases your risk of anxiety and depression. It can affect your immune system, so you may be more likely to get infections. There's some evidence to suggest that it might increase your risk of high blood pressure, possibly cancer, possibly obesity. Also, poor work performance and job performance and poor reaction time. In fact, they found that if you have been sleep deprived for 2 weeks, your level of mental alertness is on par with someone who is legally drunk. So
oh
it really
goodness.
Can affect it.
Very dramatic.
And the risk of accidents is real because, you know, if you've gotten a bad night's sleep, you can experience what's called micro sleep the next day, which means you sort of doze off for a short period of time. It might be half a second, might be 2 or 3 seconds.
Oh my goodness.
But if you're driving on the highway, I don't know if you've experienced it, but I have, and you're tired and you're on the highway and you're kind of nodding off. If you fall asleep for 3 seconds and you're driving 60 miles an hour, you have traveled 250 miles per hour asleep.
That's
and
terrifying.
Easily could drive off the road or run into another car.
Absolutely so. Terrifying. Now, is there any chance of recovering lost sleep, catching up, as it were?
Everybody asks me that, and the answer is no.
Oh.
You cannot get 6 hours of sleep a night during the week and then sleep 12 hours on Friday night and expect to make it up. However, if you get a bad night's sleep and you nap the next day, that sort of gets added to your sleep total, and that can be beneficial.
So naps are always helpful.
Naps are great.
Dr. Marshall, thank you so much for being with us today.
Thanks, Tanya.